Hello, my name is Mike Harmon, better known as Mr. Mike, and I'm the captain of the safety team. And today, you're gonna see the safety team perform a skit on how not to act on the school bus. We're also gonna teach the danger zones on the inside and the outside of the school bus, that if you're too close to the school bus and you can touch the school bus, you're in a danger zone. We're gonna do the inside of the school bus. We're gonna teach you about the safety that's on the inside of the school bus. We're also gonna show you some of the safety equipment on the inside of the school bus, as well as the safe crossing and the universal hand signal that we use so the kids can cross the school bus safely. We also want the kids to know that they need to be at their bus stop 10 minutes before their scheduled time. This allows them to walk to their bus stop and not have to run. We don't want anybody to get hurt at the bus stop. We also want you motorists to understand that the bus does make frequent stops. We are sorry for any type of delay or inconvenience, but remember, we are picking up your child, our future.
Mike, didn't I tell you not to play in the street? You're supposed to be on the curb when the bus pull up, not playing in the street.
I wasn't in the street. It was Sean and
Do not play in the street. You can get hit by a car. Go have your seat. Sean, hold on to the rail and not Cherie. Robin, how many minutes are you supposed to be on that bus stop early?
I would have left for Miss Grace.
I don't remember.
You're supposed to be on your bus stop 10 minutes early.
But my mom told me that you could stop at my house since you drive right by it.
No, you have to be on the bus stop like the other kids, 10 minutes early and in a safe spot, not playing in the street.
Yes, ma'am.
Go have your seat.
Mike, switch seat!
Mike, stay in your designated seat. Is your name on that seat?
Oh, Mike, to what about?
Mike and Cherie, stop fighting. Cherie, bring me the ball. Bring me the ball.
This is my show and tell ball.
Bring the ball to me. Sean, do not trip Mike.
I didn't trip. Am I going to get it back?
When it's time for you to get off the bus. Now go have a seat. In your seat. Robin, get your feet out the air. The bus is in motion, so y'all stay in y'all seat.
Dickie, knock my hat off.
Dickie, keep your hands to yourself.
Fight! Miss Grayson!
Robin and Mike, sit in your seat and stop fighting. Robin!
He grabbed my neck.
No, I didn't.
Robin, have a seat. Keep your hands to yourself. Tamika, are you back there eating?
No, ma'am.
Can you come up here and put that in the trash?
I can't get to school in time to get my breakfast. I always plan to come home.
Okay, you see how I have to stop the bus so y'all can get in order? Sit down, Sean. Sit back to back, bottom to bottom. Robin, get your feet out the air. Cherie, I can see you too. Mike, keep your hands to yourself.
I'm not touching her.
Mike, how did you end up way back there? Cherie?
Oh!
Miss Gracie! Robin took my hat. We don't end up.
Emily took this hat.
I did not take this hat.
Have a seat.
Here, crybaby.
Mike, I can see you coming up the aisle.
In the middle of the aisle.
Mike, get out the aisle, sit in your seat back to back, bottom to bottom. Robin, sit down.
Robin is a bully. Robin is a big bully.
Robin, do not be a bully on the bus.
I want to go home.
Mike, get in that window.
Leave me alone. I want to go home, Miss Gracie.
Mike, sit down and stop hanging out the window. That can be dangerous. Cherie and Mike, come to the front of the bus.
Yeah, right in front of the bus. Gracie.
Big white crab, baby.
Miss Gracie.
You're
tattletaling. I
want to
go home.
Sean, you cannot go home right now, but you have to stop calling me because I cannot concentrate on the road if you standing behind me calling me.
That's what I'm talking about. That's my song.
Cherie has a cell phone.
Cherie, put all your electronics in your backpack before I take them.
But we can't.
Oh, he hit me!
I did not.
Sean, why are you moving? You are not in your seat, and then you'll go back there crying because somebody hit you.
Crying.
Be quiet.
If you don't have anything nice to say, do not say anything at all.
Say bye.
Cherie and Mike. Cherie, sit in your seat. Mike, keep your hands off of Cherie. Dickie, go back to your seat.
Damn,
my mama on you.
They back here playing pussy.
Can you stop calling me?
Cherie, stop my hat off. Did you see that?
Cherie, leave Sean alone.
That's my good hat.
What's this handle for?
Oh!
Oh!
Oh. Robin!
She's doing the emergency exit!
Robin, you're gonna get in trouble!
When we get to this school, we're gonna have to call the principal for you all.
What's that?
The lights are on! Okay, the lights are on!
Lights on!
Okay, we are gonna have silence on the bus.
Miss Gracie!
Yes, Emily.
Can I spend the night with you if my mama says so?
I'm sorry, no.
I'm back here picking on Dickie.
Robin, I said stop being the bus bully.
I've been bus bully.
Bus 94 to T. Can you call Darrington Elementary and have Miss Haley come meet my bus? Thank you.
I had to disturb you, but the kids on the bus today were out of control.
All of them?
All of them.
Not me.
Put your hand down. I'm not pleased one bit. Not at all. Each of you have been through the bus safety training and you know what's expected of you. Lights on means it's supposed to be quiet on this bus. Back to back and bottom to bottom is the way you're supposed to be seated. As you are now, your parents will be contacted. You have a referral for their behavior.
Thank you.
We care about you, and getting you to and from school is very important. We have to do it safely, and you're not helping matters when you act this way. We're going to my office. Your parents will be contacted, and you will receive consequences. Let's go. Starting with you, Mike. Each of you, come on. Thank you.
Hello, boys and girls.
Hello.
My name is Miss Gracie, and I'm a Lynchburg City School bus driver, and I'm also on the school bus safety team. Today, we're going to talk about the danger zones on the outside of a school bus. Can you all say danger zone?
Danger zone!
We never want to get caught in the danger zone. Anytime you can touch a school bus, you're in a what?
Danger zone!
So always stand 3 big steps away from a school bus. You never want to cross behind a school bus because if the bus driver can't see you and you can't see the bus driver, you're in a what?
Danger zone!
So always make sure you on your bus stop 10 minutes early. That keeps you out the danger zone. Never come close to the tires of a school bus because the tires are big as most of you. And if you're near the tires, you're near a danger zone. If you drop your homework, your lunch money, your backpack under the bus, are you gonna get it?
No.
Why?
Because it's a danger zone.
And we never want to get caught in the danger zone. So, let's come to the front of the bus. We ask that you be on your bus stop 10 minutes early so that you won't be in the danger zone and that you can be away from the curb and standing there safely so when the bus pull up, the bus driver can see you and you can see the bus driver. If you're loading a bus, are you gonna be at the door like this?
No.
Can you touch the door?
No.
If I was standing here like this, you can touch the door. So you stand 3 big steps away from the door. So when the bus driver pull up and open the door, you won't be near the door. And that keeps you out of the danger zone. So if you drop anything under the bus, are you gonna get it?
No.
Why?
It's a danger zone.
How many minutes early are you going to be on your bus stop?
10.
And if the bus driver can't see you and you can't see the bus driver, what are you in?
A danger zone.
So let's stay out of the danger zones.
My name is Emily Covington and I drive bus 90 for Lynchburg City Schools. And I'm going to go over a little bit about being able permitted to ride another bus that's not normally your permanent bus. You have to have a note brought home from your parents to the school with the principal have signed it and brought it back to the bus driver stating that you have permission to ride that bus that particular day. If you do not have a note, you will not be permitted to ride the bus. That is Lynchburg City Schools rules and the bus drivers have to abide by them, same as the students do. If you're on a certain bus and you normally don't ride that bus, if a mishap should come up, we would have that note stating that you had permission to ride that bus. And we would know your whereabouts. It is very important to get it signed by the principal and brought to the bus driver.
Hi, my name is Miss Robin and I am a member of the safety team. And I'm going to talk to you about riding the bus safely. When you're riding the bus, you are supposed to sit how? And book bag in your lap, or instrument, or lunchbox, or books, or anything you have is supposed to go in your lap so that everyone will have room to sit. Nothing will be in the aisle, blocking the aisle. When we're riding the bus, are we supposed to stick our arms, our hands, our heads or anything out of the window?
No.
No, because if we do, we're in a
danger zone.
Exactly. Never stick any part of your body or anything else out of the window. It's very important. Also, when you're coming up onto the bus, you're supposed to hold the handrail and walk slowly. Get in your seat. No running, no jumping, no standing in the seat, no turned around backwards. No hanging on the edge of the seat while you're riding. Always stay clear of the aisle. Also, we have emergency evacuation. In the event there is an emergency, there are several ways to get off the bus. Any window that you see that has black rubber around it, which is the windshield, or in the back of the bus, those can be kicked out. There's an emergency exit window on both sides of the bus, right in the middle. And if the bus exits were blocked, the back and the front, you could use the windows to get out. There's a hatch in the top of the bus. If the bus were to turn over on its side, you would open that up to get out if you couldn't get out any other way. Also, we have a fire extinguisher. We have reflector triangles. We also have a first aid kit that has Band-Aids and bandages. And we have a body fluid cleanup kit. And all of those things are part of the emergency evacuation in the event you would have an accident of some sort that will require the use of those. Okay? Make sure that you do not ever eat on the bus. And do you know why?
You can get choked.
You can get choked, exactly. It's not just to keep a mess off the bus, it's to make sure you do not get choked. And getting choked is not where you're coughing and getting choked. It's where your airway gets blocked and you cannot breathe. So all these rules are not to keep you from having a good time, it's to keep you safe. So always remember those things, okay? All right, thank you.
My name is Juanita Jones. I'm going to be talking to you about getting off the bus safely in an emergency. There are several ways to exit the bus, and that is the front door, the rear, and we have two side window exits. We have a procedure where if you're at the hump of the bus, from here back, we proceed out the back door. From this seat forward, we go out the front door. You want to go a seat at a time, alternating each seat. In an emergency, we never exit the bus when there are power lines down on the bus. The emergency windows, you open them and push them out. All right, we also have a roof hatch. And normally we use those if the bus turns over and the exits, the front exit and back exit is blocked in the side window, we would go out the hatch. There's also a procedure that we use to exit the bus in an emergency with the back door. We would open the door. We would make sure the door is latched tightly so it doesn't close. And there's a proper procedure that we use. You never want to jump off of the bus. You want to sit down and scoot off. Once you exit the bus, we want everybody to move to a safe spot away from the bus, preferably 45 degree angle away from the bus.
My name is Mr. Jones. I will be talking to you all today about how to cross safely in the mornings and afternoons upon arriving and exiting your bus. When exiting your bus, you always want to make sure you use your handrails. Take your time stepping down the steps. Once you get to your bottom step, you want to use your handrail. When you're using your handrail exiting the bus, you want to look to your left, look to your right, your left again, and step off. The reason for this is because it could be joggers, there could be people walking their dogs, and we don't want anyone to get ran over. Upon exiting your bus, you always want to step out where you can see the driver and your driver can see you. You want to look to your left, look to your right, to your left again, look at your driver, proceed to the curb, to the edge of the bumper. Once you're at the bumper, you want to look to your left, look to your right, to your left again, and look at your driver. Once your driver gives you the signal, then you proceed to cross. In the mornings, Same thing apply. You want to make sure, first of all, that you're at your bus stop 10 minutes early. Also, when you're at the curb at your bus stop, you want to make sure you're three good steps back from the curb in a single file line. So that's one behind another. Step up, and you step behind him, and you step behind them. You want to be single file, because the simple fact is when you're crossing, you want to make sure you can see your driver. Once you can see your driver can see you. You wait, you look to your left, look to your right, your left again, back at your driver. He will motion you to cross. You proceed to cross in a single file line, under control, no plane. Once he blow the horn, you stop and you proceed back. So about face, and you will go back. Once you do this, the procedure starts all over again. You get back to your stop, single file line, look to your left, look to your right, look to your left again, and you look back at your driver. He will motion you across hand signal. Once he gives you the hand signal, you want to stay on the outside of your yellow crossing arm. So stay to the outside, and you proceed to load onto the bus. Once again, when you're getting on the bus, use your handrails, watch your step, no running, because we don't want nobody to fall or get hurt. Also, you want to make sure at all times, once you're exiting, When exiting and getting on the bus, you always want to make sure that your red flashing light's on and your stop sign is out. Reason being, sometimes cars, even though this bus is yellow and all the lights and pretty lights are on, people still tend to run the signs. So you want to make sure that you always look left, look right, look at your driver for the hand signal, and make sure your red amber lights are flashing at all times for safety purposes. This concludes the exiting and crossing of the bus.
Good morning. My name is Miss Cherie. I'm a substitute bus driver / trainer for Lynchburg City Schools. Today I'm going to be talking to you about bus referrals. With a bus referral, if you act up on a bus, I like to do a 3-strike rule. You act up, I give you a warning. The second time, I'm gonna talk to the principal. The third time, I'm gonna talk to your parent. If that don't work, then I have to go through different measures. With the bus referral, if you get in trouble on the bus and you get put off the bus, that means if you have a field trip with the school, that means you will not be able to ride the school bus for that field trip. You will not be able to go. So that means that your parent will have to bring you and take you home. We do not want to get any of these referrals. We want you students to be on your best behavior at all times.
Remember that our future does start here. And we want our children to be safe going to and from school. So please, continue to watch out for our students as they board the school bus and as they get off the school bus. And remembering that we are a team, and a team is a group of individuals working together to achieve one common goal. And that common goal is to get our kids to and from school safely. We thank you, and we hope that you have a wonderful and safe school year. Thank you.